סעיף א', קורא אותה מהלך או עומד או שוכב או רוכב על גבי בהמה או יושב, אבל לא פרקדן, דהן שפנה תוחות בקרקע או מושלג על גבו ופנה למעלה, אבל קורא והוא שוכב על צידו. A person can read the Shema Yisrael, he can. He's allowed to read Shema Yisrael while walking, right, while standing, while lying down, right, while riding on a donkey, let's say, or yoshev, or sitting down, אבל לא פירק דן, but he cannot be lying down and facing heaven, it's the sky. Or he's lying down and he's facing the ground. כהן שפנה תוחות בקרקע. כהן
שפנה שזו יובליזו נפסטיר, אז קרוב תרוסה.
נהיה. שייצא אותי תוז'ה בסים. הוא מושלח על גבו, או he's lying down on his back, הוא פנה למעלה and he's facing the sky, like we said, אבל קורא והוא שוכב על צידו. But he's allowed to read while he's inclining on his side, and he's lying down on his side. That is allowed.
Which side?
No, not tusach. Doesn't matter which side. Any side is fine. Miachas shekvar shochev ve'iket ircha la'amod. Because since he's already laying down, he has trouble. He doesn't want to go through the effort to getting up again, sitting. He doesn't want to do that. He just wants to do laying down. He's already so tired from learning Torah the whole day or working.
It's a zviyala pokrovat mozhno.
Да. אם היה בעל בשר הרבה ואין יכול להתהפך על צידו או שהיה חולה נוטה מעט לצידו וקורא. Person is sick or person is very heavy, he cannot move. He should move it to the side a little bit, move to the side and reach my side is also fine. Okay? Now, why is a person not allowed to read while he's lying on his back or his face in the ground with his face? Right? Why is he not allowed to reach my side? So Mishnah Berurah says, אפילו מוטה מעד על צידו גם כן אסור, even if he's inclined to the side a little bit, it's also אסור, ושנראה כי מקבל עליו עול מלכות שמיים דרך שררה וגאווה. Because people, kings usually do this, they're lying down with גאווה, with a lot of pride and ego, and they want to accept מלכות שמיים, the yoke of heaven. You cannot, you're showing גאווה before Hashem, you cannot do that. שכבר שוכב רוצה לומר, הוא פשר כל מה שעלה ועיקה תורה לעמוד ולחזור ולבשר, אבל אם שוכב וחלוק יוצא לעמוד. Mishnah Berurah wants to explain what the Rama says. Rama says, if you're really lying down, you don't want to go to the effort of getting up. So Mishnah Berurah says, what's the effort? What's the big deal? Get up and say Shema Yisrael. Right? He's asking indirect question here. What does Mishnah Berurah want? He says, this is what the Rama says. It doesn't mean it's an effort to get up and sit down. Shema Yisrael, that's not the problem here. The problem is he already took off all his clothes. Now he has to put all his clothes on back again to cover himself, and then he has to sit and say Shema Yisrael. That's what he's talking about. But if you have your clothes on, he says, and you're lying down, so get up. What's the big deal? Right? So get up and sit and say Shema Yisrael. That should not be a problem.
But when you say Shema Yisrael, you can say it while you're sitting, right? But what about Vidu? You have to stand up. You do have Vidu said before you go to sleep.
Right. ויכול, אבל אם יכול להתהפך על צידו ואפילו רק בפסוק ראשון לבד, מחויב לעשות כן, וכל שכן, וכל שכן יכול לקרותה בישיבה. כן? What is it going on? ואין יכול? Oh, so we're talking about a person who's very big, right? And he cannot turn. And he cannot turn, right? He says a person is allowed to reach my Israel while he's laying down. So the Mishnah Berurah says, אבל אם יכול להתהפך על צידו, but if he's able to turn on his side, אפילו רק בפסוק ראשון לבד, just for the first פסוק בשמע ישראל, מחויב לעסוק, he's obligated to do so, because שכן יכול לקרותה בישיבה, and for sure it says, כל שכן, he should, if he's able to sit down and say שמע ישראל, that's more right, that's better. Brings down the case from the Nishmat Abraham. His person is in the hospital, right? Who said, you cannot reach my soul while you're lying down on your back. But let's say the hospital bed, they raise it, they could raise your head higher, right? Mm-hmm. Or you're on pillows, he says. But today they could raise it higher. That's also good, he says. If they could raise the bed higher and you reach my soul, it's also fine. Okay, next halacha.
As long as you're not flat.
Right. מי שרוצה להחמיר לעמוד כשהוא יושב ולקרותה מעומד נקרא עבריין. If a person is sitting down and says, you know, I want to stand up and reach my kavana, he's called a rasha.
Why?
Oh, why? Because, let's see if he brings it down. Oh, he does bring it down. Okay, here you go. The halacha kibid hilel. Okay, so there's a Mishnah. When the Torah says, uveshach v'chal v'kumecha, you should sit, lie down, and when you get up, say Shema Yisrael. Right? But Shammai holds that lie down and getting up, what that says in Shema Yisrael, if you read the translation, it means literally sitting down, lying down, and getting up when you say Shema Yisrael. You should get up, say Shema, or lie down. But Beit Hillel says that it's not talking about lying down, getting up physically. It's talking about the time. And so you're talking about the time of Shema Yisrael. When you lie down is when you're going to sleep. When you get up is in the morning. You understand? Okay. The halacha kibid hilel, the sefer hilel, the hadaf dichtiv uv kumecha. This is what it says, uv kumecha, when you get up. Ena kavana be'amida. It doesn't mean getting up, standing. Ki dar b'shama lai b'shama. Ela b'zma shederib ne'adan lakum imitatan. It's talking about the time when people get up to say, when they get up from bed. He's not allowed to do like Beit Shammai. Because like we said, remember the Gemara says, the voice came out, they said, Halach is like Beit Hillel, you know? Okay, but feel him, ena kavana ba'amidato la'asok ki Beit Shammai. And even he's getting up, not because like Beit Shammai. He just wants to get up. He just wants to have kavana. He feels that he has good kavana, right? He's in proper thought of mind when he's getting up. Right? Even so is asur, you know what to do. You cannot say Shema Yisrael standing up if you're already sitting down.
Oh, so I cannot say it.
Even again, in the morning? Even
if you are standing already, you want to say Shema Yisrael, it's not a problem. But if you're sitting and you want to stand up to say Shema Yisrael, that's a problem. You call the Rasha. You're going against Halacha.
Sometimes when I pray, if I stand, say Shema, it's fine.
If you're standing already. But if you're intentionally stand up for Shema Yisrael, you're not allowed to.
Of course. Gotta be.
This is both for Шахри
если облокотиться в аэропорту вы стоите в очереди и
но же в аэропорту же не сидел ты стоял я же говорю не проблема когда ты сидел ты сидишь я говорю шмайся время а окей значит встанем все
на самолете скажем летите молиться скажем Шахри
сидите да даже амида можно слышу правда.
В машине тоже, в трене тоже.
Ну, если я вижу, скажем, в самолете, скажем, летать, ну, там хасиды, может, стоя. А мне как-то...
Ты должен с ним стоять.
Да, ну, мне как-то стесняюсь, неудобно возле него. Ну, как-то, не знаю.
Почему?
Просто вопрос спрашиваю, я не знаю.
If you feel comfortable sitting down on a plane, you should sit down on a plane.
But even though he's standing on a plane, yeah.
Of course, yeah. בין ביום ובין בלילה. This law applies day or night. ואף על פי כן, אין צריך בזה לחזור ולקרוא בדיעבד. But let's say you did already standing up. Yeah, you are Russia. You called עבריין. But you already did the mitzvah. You did the mitzvah read, so you don't have to read it again. Okay. Next. היה מעלה בדרך ורצה לקרוא קריאה שמע, צריך לעמוד בפסוק ראשון. If a person is walking in the street, he's walking somewhere far, and the time was Kriya Shema came, you cannot just walk and say Kriya Shema. This is what we said, a person could walk and say Kriya Shema. It's talking about the three paragraphs of Kriya Shema. But the first pasuk has to be said standing. If you're already walking, I'm saying. And there's nowhere, and there's no place to sit.
Stop and say, yeah?
Stop. Say Shema Yisrael with Kavana, and then you're allowed to walk and say the other three paragraphs. But Baruch Shem Kavod is also included in the first pasuk, you should know. היה מעלה בדרך ורצה לקרוא קריאת שמע צריך לעמוד בפסוק ראשון. רוצה לומר להתעכב במקום אחד ומותר לקרוא אותה בין במדבר בין בישיבה ואפילו לקרוא קריאת שמע של ערבית ודאג אם ישנה. So he said, if you're walking, you want to do sitting down, standing, whatever you want to do is fine, he says. Because there's no place to sit anyway, so he's standing. עיקר הכוונה הוא פסוק ראשון. The main kavan of Shema Yisrael is in the first pasuk of Shema Yisrael. Hilkach. אם קרא ולא כיוון ליבו בפסוק ראשון, ליצא ידי חובתו, וחוזר ויקורא, ואפילו למען דעם המצווה אין סוף הכוונה, מודה הכן. He says, in the first pasuk, if a person did not have proper kavana, you have to go back and read Shema Yisrael. I mean, the first pasuk. Again, you have to read it. The kavana to be yotze the mitzvah, and the second kavana is to be mikavah on yourself the Omachut Shamayim, Hashem's Yoko for heaven.
What's the proper kavanah? What should we have in our mind when we say Shema?
I want to be Yoitzi the Mitzvah of Shema Israel, of Kriyat Shema. We have the kavanah. And then your kavanah, eight worlds, four sides, you know, the second kavanah. אם היה ישן, if person is sleeping, מצערים אותו, מעירים אותו, עד שיקרה פסוק ראשון, ויהיו ער ממש. If person went fell asleep, your friend fell asleep, you're in the same bunk, he fell asleep, it's time to Kriyat Shema, and he is out. And you know if you don't wake him up, he's going to miss Kriyat Shema. You're allowed to wake him up. You wake him up for the first pasuk, it should be complete awake. And the next three paragraphs, if he's half awake, he's also fine. But the first pasuk gets to be awake. Okay? Maya Yeshu Mitzarim Otom Meirim Otom Ah Sheikra Pasuk Rishon Vio Er Mamash Mikam Ve'elach Em Mitzarim Otom Kde Sheikra Vio Er Mamash Shav Vishu Kore Mitandem Yatsa He's half asleep, he's also okay. Ve'din Shatu Vishikor Ayn Lekaman And we're going to talk about person who's drunk later on, it says in Siman Tzadik Tet. Akore Kriya Shema Lo Yirmoz Be'enav Person reading Shema, he says he's not to show with his eye. He's not allowed to. Or with his mouth. He's showing signs. He's not allowed to. When he's saying Kriyat Shema, it's you and God. Finished. The words of Kriyat Shema, that's it. You cannot do anything when you're saying Kriyat Shema. It's very important. לא ירמוז בעיניו ולא יקרוז בשפתיו ולא יראה בעזבותיו of showing with fingers בפרשה הראשונה at the first parasha שהוא עיקר קבלת עול מלכות שמיים because that's the main part where you accept the yoke of heaven upon yourself מפני שנראה כי קורא הרי because when you're showing it's not important right? וכתיב ידברת בם ודרשינן עשה אותה קבע you have to make it קבע you have to make it mean the whole כוונה should be on the first pasuk היה עושה במלאכה ורצה לקרוא קריאה שם person is doing מלאכה today He went to work, let's say, right? Early. He didn't read Shema Yisrael, he didn't daven. But you say Shema Yisrael at work. You're working. I don't know, whatever you're doing. Question is, what are you doing when you're working? Itbatim melachto ad shikra parasha rishona kdei shelo yehi ki korel arai. He says, whatever you're doing, you stop. You say Shema Yisrael, and then you continue working. האומנים וכן בעל הבית שהיו עושים מלאכה בראש אלם או בראש שורות הבניין קוראים קריאת שמע במקומה ואין הצליחים לרד. If a person is collecting, let's say, olives, he's on a tree, he doesn't have to come down to reach my Israel. On the olive tree, you close your eyes and you say Shema Israel. האומנים וכן בעל הבית שהיו עושים מלאכה בראש אלם או בראש שורות הבניין קוראים קריאת שמע במקום ואין הצליחים לרד. הכתב אף על פי שמשאו על כתפו קורא קריאת שמע. Person needs to carry heavy loads on their back, right? He's allowed to read קריאת שמע while carrying. אבל לא יתחיל בשעה שטועים ולא בשעה הכתב אף על פי שמשאו על כתפו קורא קריאת שמע אבל לא יתחיל בשעה שטועים ולא בשעה שפורג מפני שאין ליבו מיושר. But he should not read while he's putting it on. Or while he's taking it off, because now his kavana is not 100%. If you're already carrying it for a couple of minutes already, you're already into it already. You don't feel the load anymore. You just walking, you stop, you say Kriyat Shema. But to put it on, initially and say Kriyat Shema at that moment, you're not allowed to.
What about driving?
You have to stop the car.
If you drive, you're sitting on the highway, you see that you're driving. So then I will say the Shema Yisrael.
I think driving, since you're sitting. Yeah, but you don't have kavana because you're driving.
Brachot
is something you'll talk about Shema Yisrael. The problem is, he says over here.
That's what I'm saying. The problem is,
he says. He says over here like this.
When you're in the bed, you're allowed to
sit. He says over here like this.
You have to
sit up. No. שהקורא קריאת שמע לא ירמוז בעיניו ולא יקרוס בשפתיו ולא יראה באצבעותיו. All these things show because you're driving, you're looking, you know. You should not be allowed, I don't know. You see?
But regular walking?
You're not allowed to, you have to stand right there. No, you have to stop.
Yes, חזר ты идешь в синагогу.
You have to stop. For the first pasuk, you stop.
No, just when I say, а другие?
Stop. You could walk.
You can walk. I can't stop. Stop.
First one. Okay, here we go. Hayar Khagar Behima Tala Surah Behima Shikra Pasukrishon. You see? If a person is on an animal, on a donkey, let's say.
Yeah,
right?
So this is a car,
it's a
donkey. If you're a driver, you have to stop the car. If you're a passenger, you're not totally
clear. Yeah, because you have kavana passenger.
Passenger
is not a problem because you have the kavana, because you're not driving. Very good. Right. Okay, we're going to do another parak and then we're going to stop here. Samech Dalet. Dina Toebi Kriyat Shema. If a person makes a mistake in Kriyat Shema, you have four Sifim here. Okay. Karali Mafriya Lo Yatsa. If a person read Shema Yisrael backwards. You read Shema Yisrael backwards. You hear? Pemei Devar Amorim B'Seda Psukim. He read the Psukim backwards. You know, let's say the first paragraph, right? You read the last Pasuk and then the before the last Pasuk, the third, like this you're reading. Like this you're reading, from bottom to top.
Why?
You're not allowed to.
Why would you do that?
Whatever reason he has, he did that. But if a person, let's read the Parasha of Tzitzit first, and then the after, and then the Ayah, you're allowed to. If you did it, it's okay. You shouldn't do it. You should read the Seder. But if you did it, you're Yotze. But reading it backwards in the Psukim, you're not allowed to. Because even in the Torah, it's not the order. The Torah is different orders. Right? Next, Halacha. A person read the Parasha and he made a mistake. He knows where he made a mistake. He goes, he skipped a pasuk in the middle. He goes back to the beginning of that paragraph. He goes back to that pasuk where he missed. He don't know what you missed, so you go back to the chapter. He goes back to the parasha. Gimel. He doesn't know which paragraph he's in. He's reading by heart. He has no clue where he is. Go back all the way back. Okay, because the first two parashiot, the first two have words are similar. So it says if you read the first and the second here, Tavim parasha le parasha shuyodesh isem parasha ven yodeh im rishona im shniya. Finish this first or second. Chozel parasha rishona. Yatchil v'ayem shamoa. If I am shamoa, he's not for his second already. Okay. So he says the second one. Very good. Okay. Haya umed ubichtavtam. ואין יודע אם הוכתבתה שפרשה ראשונה ואם הוכתבתה שפרשה שנייה חוזה והוכתבתה שבראשונה. See the word uchtavtam you have in the first and second parasha, but he doesn't know where he's standing, so you go to the first parasha. That's only when he didn't start l'man yirbo yimechem, because that's for sure in the second parasha already. So you have to go back. The sikh and akad ata, it's already a habit, it's flow with the flow of words. He's saying it. Very good. That's it.
Well, the kavanah you have to have for the parashiot is the same thing as the kavanah you have to have for
Shema Yisrael. I want to say small divrei Torah. We have 2 minutes. Let's say small divrei Torah on the parasha. Okay.
See.
The story is like this. Hashem told Avraham on the parasha. He said, "Go and I'll make your name great." Right? Now, so Avraham goes. Torah says, and Avraham did exactly what God told him. Right? Some said that was one of the tests of Avraham that he left. I'm gonna ask you a question. If God says to Avraham, "I'll give you a great name," right? He has his own coins. He says. The Gemara said he has no coins. Back and front is an old lady, old man. In the other side is young man, young lady, right? Everybody knew Abraham. Everybody knew Abraham Avinu. He had kids because he left. So God gave him money, he gave him kids, he gave him a great name. So I don't say, what's the test? What are you testing me on? If you tell me go, I'll give you $1 million. Okay, I'll go. What's the problem? Give me kids, wife. Very good. Mordechai, what's the test here? Here? That says like this. No? Baruch.
No, I was not focused. I'm sorry.
Hashem told Avram, go, and I'll give you 3 things. Right? Yeah. That was his test.
Right.
What's the test?
The test is like this. Usually when you go in other city, first of all, you bring 3 things that you're going down.
But God said, I'll give you. After the fact, God said, I'll give you. Name, kids, everything I'll give you. Bracha.
Maybe to start on a different
time. So good, so yeah, God said, I'll give you. Hashem said, don't worry about the trees, I'll give you everything.
Kids?
Everything I'll give you. So what's the test of Abraham? What is he doing exactly? He's going, I'm happy I'm going, what's the problem?
Well, you could say no.
The answer's like this. It says, Abraham did like Hashem said. Abraham didn't go because of these 3 things.
Faith.
Abraham went because Hashem told him to go. And who knows that? Only Hashem knows why Abraham went. Hashem said, you know why Abraham went? Not because I promised him these things. He went because I told him to go. That was the test. The test was, when he does go, what's his initial thought? What is he thinking about? Oh, God said money? I'm there.
No,
Hashem said, you failed. But when he left his home, his father's home, he didn't go because Hashem promised him all these things, the castle and the car and BMW. That's not why he went. So he says he went because God said go. He wasn't even thinking about the other things. But he went to the go, okay, I'm going.
Wait a second. So why he asked him on the parasha, Ben Eliezer, you're Roshuti?
Wait a second.
What are you saying? I trust God.
There's nothing to do with this.
I'm not saying that. So what's the question that has come to him by God?
Because
he can ask if where is he, you have got 2 questions. He can say, God, you promised me, first of all, where is the whatever you promised? Second one, if you already believe in God, that everything, so why are you asking that? Ben Energy or Shuti, you're supposed to be the child, silent. You understand that?
What is this?
No. What I'm trying to say, okay, we go ahead.
This is a
good question. One step over.
Okay.
Already he lived until 99. 20 years passed by.
Right.
He can say, God, wait a second. I did whatever you tell me. Say, if you believe in God, so don't ask why Ben Esher or Shuti. If say that, so if he believe in God, so why ask this question?
But the point is not of belief here.
No, I'm not talking about this, whatever you say. Yeah, I like the pirush that you give me. It's 100%, 100%. It's just very sure. We go into the other episode after 20 years.
In the end of the parasha, Avraham Avinu says that he will inherit me.
Why?
Because a tzaddik, he never relies on a mess. He always wants the teva he wants. Right? He wants everything natural. He doesn't like the nisim.
I take that. But so if you believe in bread, so why ask this question to Hashem? Ben Ezra Yoroshuti.
That's not a question. He said, let him be Yoroshuti, he says. I don't want nisim. Let him be my son. No, he said something. You did talk about something else. No, he said, how will I know? He said, that my son will inherit me. How do I know? And that question was not about inheritance. This was something else. It's a long story to what he's talking about. The Hashem gave all the signs, the birds and the korbanot. That dream is a big, big etter. It's not, we're not going to go into that right now. On Shabbat, you ask the question on Shabbat, I'm explaining. We have a whole hour to explain. What?
Shabbat Chatam.
Jason?
No.
Oh, you're not coming?
I don't know.